baby njalo nje. Thana ma baby njalo nje. Yale 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 yale. Hello baby, mntwana sekhasini, nikeza ithuba mfuna ukuthethana. Hello baby, mntwana sekhasini, nikeza ithuba mfuna ukuthethana.
Thema ngifike ekhasi zola kusungabona intombe yaseGoli. Sangani khanda ngibamba lana ngiyeka lana, then my friends told me I'm slow. Shango high and I'll shine your smile, nomntwana uyababa, now take my hand. Wozange xoxela indaba bambo lwami nayisala phansi, and I'm singing like.
When we built the theatre complex, we needed a group to be a resident ensemble in the theatre, and due to our geographic location, of course, an orchestra, a band, or ensemble would be a little bit difficult because you'd require instrumental tuition, so the obvious choice was a choir, and I put my hand up and said, please can I do it? So it was, yeah, that's how I got involved 10 years ago, and we started the choir, and it's just been the most amazing journey. Yeah, well, the decision to do Shape of You was because the song has got Caribbean roots. There's a strong Caribbean flavour in the original, which of course is most good music links back to Africa, so it had a strong African connection, and I felt, as an arranger, I enjoy arranging and composing, that it's something that I think I could give a bash and try and create a Zulu version of it. So we worked very, very hard on it. It was a collaboration with myself and the choristers. I'd come up with the lines and the rhythms and the harmonies, and they'd help with the words. And we never in our wildest dreams expected the response. We thought 50,000 views would be great. And if you combine YouTube and Twitter and Facebook and all other social platforms, we're over 2 million. And it's a dream come true. When the first ones came, we tried to get all the comments and put them, collate them for the kids and print them, because the kids don't have access to data and cell phones yet. But by about day 3 or 4, we just gave up. But it was great. We could give at least a few pages of comments and say, guys, this is what everyone around the world thinks of you. You're awesome. I would love them to see the processes of excellence and what creates excellence, and if they can see that, they can apply it to whatever they wish to pursue for their lives, but also ideally also to create employment for them. If we could do enough work on the scene in South Africa and internationally, we believe that we have a product that we can sell and create employment within the arts in this area, and would probably be the first arts organization in the world that would have successfully transformed itself from being donor dependent to self-sufficient into a job creation. So we're a long way from it, but that's our dream.